Hey. Aw, oh, man. Rest in peace, bruh. This is classic. I mean, this is beyond classic, B. This is... Big L. Okay. Let's talk about Big L for a second. Let me lower this. Big L, man. Unfortunate loss, obviously, in hip-hop. This guy was stupid ill. I mean, I remember the first time I heard Big L was probably back in 99. I heard Big L, I think, literally right after he died. Right? Like, I heard the Ebonics remix. Remember, I was in Saudi at the time. So, the Ebonics remix, the Primo remix, was the first song by, you know, Big L I ever heard. And I was blown away. I was like, whoa, who is this guy? Like, this is some cool shit. Just, you know, breaking down all the slang and all that. Like, you have to understand, I mean, that wasn't... It was unique. You know what I mean? And I've read stories that Big L spent, like, a year making that song. Which I understand, because it's very well written. So yeah, I was a big fan of L from then. I mean, in terms of I liked his material, but I didn't really hear a lot about him because, you know, rap kept progressing and like artists like that. I mean, I'm sure he was making an impact at the time. Again, I was overseas. I was getting into rap. So it's not like I was able to really sit there and be like, yo, let me dig up everything. Like I said, music wasn't easy to come by where I was at. So I heard Big L and that was kind of it. Now, I went back to Big L and really listened to him, I think, in like 2005. And I'll say the reason for that was because I was at a club. And I'll tell you, again, why I bring this up. Because there's two things that people always forget when they discuss rap. Is that, number one, your discography is about quality. That's what really matters, right? Big L wasn't around for very long, if you really think about it, right? He had like a 5-year, you know, he came out with Devil's Son or whatever. He was around for like 5 years, right? And he's still considered to be one of the greatest rappers ever. He wasn't around very long. He doesn't have a ton of songs. But the thing is, all the songs that he recorded, they're all quality fucking songs. And of course, some of them are dumb classic, right? And that's the point. It's not about how long you've been in rap. It's about how ill you are. And whether your shit is, you know, in the top echelon of what we call this rap shit. That's what matters. It doesn't matter how long you've been doing it and... You know, how many songs. That's why we can still talk about Big being in the conversation for one of the greatest rappers ever. Because the amount of material that Big recorded, even though it's not much compared to, let's say, your whack new nigga like Young Thug, but almost everything Big recorded was ill, right? So in a way, yes, he has way more ill songs than your average person. And that's what I'm talking about. How many standout records do you really have? Right? That's how we, you know, judge how great a rapper is. So back to my story. I was out in Montreal at the time when I was living in Montreal. And they played this record. This is back then when DJs were really on some other shit. The DJs were really DJs, right? So I'm at the club. DJ drops this. Room Full of Fine Women, right? 2005 or whatever. It's in all my fucking night, so get used to it. I had never heard the song before. So I'm sitting there going like, yo, what is this shit? And the ladies is dancing. Everybody's having a great time. This beat is crazy. Mm-mm-mm. Big L. My nigga C-Town. Mm-mm. Big brother, Big Lee, holding it down. See, this is back then. Flamboyant baby. This is back then when, you know, hip-hop DJs, you went out to a hip-hop club, you got hip-hop music. You know what I mean? And I think a lot of times now, it's hard for you guys to kind of fathom that stuff. And so you guys, you know, underground rap in a way and the boom bap has been absorbed by a lot of dweebs who don't go outside, who pretend it's all about bars, but they don't even know, they don't even understand bars. They don't understand what makes a great bar to begin with. So to them, they think it's like, it's shut-in music. When in fact, the greatest rappers always made songs, even the hardest songs, they were so dope that the ladies could rock, the dudes could rock. I mean, the whole point is to get people excited, right? It's to, you know, get people like to feel you. You know what I'm saying? Like I heard the Big Picture intro for the first time in a motherfucking club. You know what I'm saying? And I was like, this record is crazy. And we were all having a great time. And that's when I started going like, you know what? I haven't really heard a lot of Big L. I had heard little things here and there, but I haven't really gone back and listened to everything that Big L did. And that's what really motivated me to go back. And I was like, all right, let me go listen to that first album. Let me go listen to the Big Picture intro, because it was like, how the fuck did I not know what the song was, right? Again, you know, if you hung out in hip-hop spaces, there are certain records that you would hear, of course. Of course, I heard Put It On, you know, before that. I heard Platinum Plus with Big Daddy Kane before that, right? But, you know, there are certain records that I really love to this day, like Holding It Down, the Pete Rock banger that I hadn't heard. So I went back and checked it out, right? Big L got a lot of nice joints, man. Again, great beats, some of the, you know, best boom-bap beats we've ever heard. You gotta have great production. I always stress this, but the great rappers all have great beats that they killed, and that's what made them stand out and make them great rappers. So, if I was to listen to Big L, where would I start if I didn't know anything about Big L? Well, I would say that you know, it's not that hard. Just listen to his first two albums. I mean, they're kind of the only things that he came out with. The one that, the original one, and then, of course, the posthumous one, The Big Picture, which I actually prefer, I would say, overall. I do think that that's his best album. Now, in terms of his favorite songs or my, you know, the best songs to me that he did, let me see if I can take a look here. So on the Lifestyles of the Poor and Dangerous, I would say my favorite song on there is Put It On, without a shred of a doubt. And it was funny because I was looking at an interview somewhere where they said they needed something more happy for Big L. And I think that that's a great look. You know, like sometimes rap can get too dark and too horrorcore-y. And you do need something that's happy but still rugged and raw. And, you know, those songs tend to last actually quite well. So Put It On is probably my favorite on there. The beat I'm playing right now, Danger Zone, is crazy. Again, you know, these are songs that people don't necessarily pay attention to in a sense, but heads know them. You know what I mean? I remember going to like a open mic session years ago. This was like maybe 2013, 2014. And someone came out rapping on the fucking Danger Zone beat. So that beat is still killer. That's what I'm telling you about a great beat. That shit is from what, 93, 94? But it still was rocking in the 2020, you know, in the 2010s. So yeah, I would say that song, those are my two favorite on it. No Ends, No Skins was cool. That's all right. You know, but anyways, those are my two favorites. Then on The Big Picture, we talk about The Big Picture intro with the, you know, the illustrious DJ Premier, who did that beat. Fantastic song. Ebonics, of course. The original and the remix. I prefer the Primo remix personally. What else is on here? 98 Freestyle is crazy. You gotta know that song. Holding It Down is crazy. The Enemy is crazy. Platinum Plus is crazy. Who You Sliding With is pretty dope. You know, so those are some of the songs I would say by L. And of course, School Days. I love School Days. I think that's a great song that he came with. So, you know, Big L got some joints, man. Anything, you know, Big L, you can hear and get your hands on, because he is really one of the greatest rappers to ever do it. Unfortunately, you know, his sort of contribution was cut short. But while he was still here, his punchlines was fucking nice, man. And Big L would say some shit that always had you going like, whoa. Like, just crazy funny. Like, you know what I'm saying? Dumb funny, but raw at the same time, you know? Definitely a legend, man. And the thing is, you know, for me, that's why growing up in my era, it's hard for me to really listen to the guys that y'all call lyricists, because honestly, I feel like I've heard the best that really rappers had to offer. You know, like, if you're not on that level, if you're not close to, like, a Big L to a certain degree, it's hard for me to really take you seriously. Like, now, I can say that you have a decent pen, but I'm not going to be really blown away by your fucking rhymes. Like, most people ain't saying a damn thing. You know what I'm saying? Big L got rhymes, you know, that stick in your fucking dome. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, unfortunately, lyricism, as we so call it, has been so watered down that people just accept whatever that seems to be lyrical, or they, whatever they call lyrical. But all that shit don't mean nothing. You know what I'm saying? Like, you need people like a Big L, like a Nas, you know what I'm saying, that really spit that shit. Look at what they're saying. If the shit don't stuck, you know, stand out to you, and you can't quote that shit, you know what I'm saying, and it don't, like, it don't hit you, it probably isn't very good. You know what I mean? Anyway, thanks for watching.